Welcome to NAB. So NAB is pretty much my favorite week of the entire year. Get to meet up with some awesome creators, see some awesome brands, and of course, new stuff being released. Now in this video, obviously, per title and thumbnail, we're talking about DaVinci Resolve 18.5, obviously not 19. And I honestly think it is a pretty solid update, and I'm happy that they called it a kind of 0.5 update rather than a 19, because while there is a ton of amazing new features, it, especially on the surface, isn't exactly a complete overhaul, or it doesn't check all the boxes that everyone was asking for. So I think if they went with 19, people would be like, oh, this isn't enough. But as a 0.5 update, we got some awesome stuff. So let's jump into it. Firstly, I gotta just like, they could have stopped the updates on the cut page now has an expanded waveform option. You guys know that I've been asking that since the inception of the cut page. And so yeah, the cut page is way more editable to myself and I know many other people out there. In my what to expect in DaVinci Resolve 19, hands down the most requested feature of everything was better captions, auto captions, just like Premiere has. And it's kind of funny, it seems like Premiere and Resolve released the same feature on the same day, basically building in Descript type features where it will one, as soon as you import all your footage, you can automatically transcribe and have captions for your entire video. That's amazing. And then of course you can go in and change all the styling and whatever. So you can have it just be nice, clean, simple captions on the bottom. Or if you want that Mr. Beast style, like very big and vibrant colored, whatever crazy font text, you can change all the parameters you want. But that's where it really introduces the heavy lifting of the, you know, AI stuff and features that everyone's coming out with. And that's going to allow you to actually edit via the text. So in the media bin, you can actually highlight the text and essentially include the words that you want to import into your timeline, essentially your in and out points, only importing the part of the footage that you actually want to include. Again, software like that, you know, Descript have existed before, but having it built inside of the NLE, I think is so important because I personally hate round tripping. I hate like having to go to too many third-party softwares to do things that are cool and maybe more efficient in that task, but by having it in a separate platform, it feels so much more inefficient. So having that built into Resolve now, huge plus. And then the other big feature that comes to mind, of course, is the relight feature, which uses some insane, like kind of depth mapping, but not depth mapping, like compositing technology to basically allow you to relight the scene, which would be helpful here. Actually, no, I'm gonna try to relight this scene right here. So my face is very much in the shadow. This is what it looks like in real life. Then this is what the relight looks like. Does it look realistic? That one I need to test out more. I saw them demo it at the booth and it looks cool, but we'll see how practical it actually is. And it's definitely not gonna be a like magical fix to like bad on-set lighting.
So after playing around with DaVinci Resolve for a while, I actually had a chance to sit down with Blackmagic and interview them. If you guys want to see the full interview, let me know down in the comments and maybe I'll upload the whole thing unlisted. But one of the most important questions I wanted to ask was talking about how they are balancing coming out with new features for professional Hollywood editors and colorists and everything, as well as, you know, us content creators and stuff like the vertical features. This year, we've definitely seen a rise in people switching to DaVinci Resolve from all various parts of the industry. And honestly, their answer on this question definitely gives me hope for a bright future for Resolve.
It's funny because I worked for DaVinci before Blackmagic bought it, right? So we only had like 100 people.
Oh, and by the way, this entire interview, I'm using the voice isolation feature inside of Resolve, which is incredibly powerful. It's on about 60% because I recorded everything at NAB with my Sennheiser MK440 stereo mic, which picks up everything. Normally, this interview sounds like this.
It's funny because I worked for DaVinci before Blackmagic bought it, right? So we only had like 100 people.
But thanks to the simple tap of voice isolation, we get much more usable dialogue audio.
It's funny because I worked for DaVinci before Blackmagic bought it, right? So we only had like 100 people that knew it around the world, right? And today it's millions and millions, and there is that balance. Now, what we find though is that a lot of times some of some of the good ideas come from both places that both sides appreciate. And I think that has been interesting because we don't just focus on the Hollywood guys for the feedback. We get it and we understand what they're looking for, but then we also try to find out how people are working and what could we do to help with that. And that's like, so that's, you know, the new software update for the pocket camera is a perfect example of that. Like, okay, yeah, I get it. You know, as much as some of us old school guys don't quite understand the whole vertical thing, but we understand that it's needed.
Clearly
used. Yeah, you know, so you have to adjust over time. That particular feature probably didn't come from the guy who shot, you know, a movie or whatever. That wasn't going to come from him, clearly. But also, you know, as the pyramid goes, right, the widest part is as in the middle towards the bottom of the, and so you do have to take care of that. I think that over this almost 14 years that they've owned, that Blackmagic has owned Resolve, I think they've proven that we're dedicated to the craft, dedicated to the product, and it is here to serve as many people that are willing to work with it. You know, a good idea is a good idea. Who decides to use it is up to whoever it is, right?
Yeah.
There's two, I mean, the cut page and the edit page are different. There are different reasons to use either one. Some people use both, some people use one or the other, and that's the way it works, and that's fine, and that's what we've done, right? Because it is difficult sometimes when you get into a tool and it's trying to do everything, trying to appease every workflow, and that's, there's more than one workflow. I think we all know that.
Do you have, like, kind of maybe an underrated or lesser talked about? It could be a new feature.
Well, so the new feature, I definitely want to play with the new audio to text because that just, you know, that's cool. The one thing I do often, because I do a lot of this talking head kind of video stuff, and I use the smooth cut every once in a while, and you can really blow people's minds with that.
So
you know?
True.
And it's funny because what I'll do is if I know I need to do a pickup edit, I'll watch the end of the last take so I know where my head is, and then I put it in so it's really good. And it's those little things that make your life easier, because otherwise you have to try and fix it some other way. And I don't want to do that.
Yeah.
So as always, I'd love to hear what you guys think about 18.5. Are you satisfied with all of the new features, or are there still big things missing for you? Let me know down in the comments below. And definitely, if you're not already, make sure you're subscribed so you don't miss out on NAB updates that I'll be editing over the next week, and of course, future videos to come. See you guys in the next video.
There's no way I get up there.